Hello and welcome to the show. I am back on my summer car, continuing trying to rebuild this thing. Although today I am going to start by hopefully going to do some food shopping, because in all of my time here I have forgotten to really watch any of my need bars. Now we have, oopsie, that's not the kitchen. Where is the kitchen? Ah, it's over here. I remember this house layout, honestly. Yeah, we need to have some food. I'm hoping, okay, good, it actually does reset my bar. That's helpful. And then if we press F on that, we will have one of the beers. We need to go to the shop. Now, the shop is the other side of, okay, that doesn't really replenish as much as I had hoped, so we're gonna have to have another one of them. I also love how the guy just sort of randomly chucks the, can we try and aim it for the sink? For the sink? Well, no, that's pretty rubbish. We're going to take the case with us, though. Okay, we're going to take the beer case with us and put it in the back of the van. Actually, we might not be going by van. Oh, good. I'm glad that doesn't break anything. don't drink and drive, guys. But on this game, it is okay. Is it swaying, or is that just me now looking down? Yeah, I'm hopefully not going to take a van. I believe there is a boat around the place. I am going to put them in here, though, just in case. It's a good idea to take stuff with you, because you never know when your needs are going to come back to haunt you in this. Right, if we can go... Right there. Is that closed now properly? There we go, okay. Oh, bugger, now I've got to go find the bloody ignition. We're enter driving mode. There we go. Ooh, camera. Okay. There. We'll get the van started up. Now, it should... In theory, from what I was reading. There we go. Van is working. I've broken my camera ever so slightly. Hold on. There we go. Enter driving mode. Handbrake off. Handbrake off fully. Okay, good. We've got a working car. Now, if everything goes according to plan, there should be a boat just on the lake over there somewhere. But I'm not quite sure where it is. Now we're in a drive, so yeah, I think I'll take the van just to go for a bit of an explore over this part, because the shop is literally the other side of the map, from what I can tell. Aha! Right, okay, that's good. That's good news. There is a jetty here with our boat. Now, fingers crossed, if we head towards that big mast, that is probably where we are supposed to be going, I would imagine. Right, so we'll turn all of that off. Didn't really need the van for this, but it was just a more of I wasn't sure where I was going. Job, that can close. We will go in here, get our case of beer. Hopefully not everything is broken. Everything isn't broken. That is good. We can dump this in the boat and then head over in that direction. Unfortunately, leaving the van here... Oh, God, I was really worried we're going to miss and end up dropping them in the water. leaving the van here doesn't mean we're going to have to walk around town. I'm hoping it's not going to be too much walking. Now... Do we have to do anything different with this? Wait, hold on. Oh, I'm standing on the food. Engine. Shut off gear select. F? F? G? It does generally help if you know how on earth the boat works. Ah! Aha! I figured it out slightly. Do we just keep doing this until it goes into life? Is there a particular trick to it? Aha! We have boating! We are boating successfully! Fantastic! Okay, we don't really have much steering in the boat, but we are boating very successfully. That's quite cool. Oh, I'm really, really liking the details going on in this game. Unfortunately, there is... Nope, that's... I was pressing M thinking it was going to be a map button. It is not. It is not a map button. what an insult as well. Right, we are going to head our way across the ocean. The beers are intact. I'm really hoping this is going to be the main town. I imagine it would be. Am I ever going to find my way back to my side of the... Probably not. Probably not, to be honest. In fact, what I might do is, on my phone, while we're doing our thing across the lake here, it's a bloody big lake, I might actually get up a map of this area. So if things get lost, if I get lost, I can look at that. Because I don't think you can take the map that's like in your house. You can't take that with you. So, whoopsie, I've knocked my mouse while I was doing all of that. Okay, that looks a lot closer. That is not close at all over there. Right, so my summer car map, if I could spell, that would be helpful. And there is, go on Google Images. There's plenty of time, plenty of bloody time to be doing this. That looks like a map to me. Right, so oh, God's sake. Camera, come back again. Where we want to be going, I think, is actually over in this far corner. So the town with the store is all the way. That radio mast is something different. The town is up this end. I'm not doing a very good job of keeping my camera looking in the right direction. Sort of this corner of the lake is kind of roughly where the town is. It's a seriously big map, this. There is an awful, awful lot to explore around, and this is why I kind of figured it would be a good idea to go and stock up on food. I'm just watching the case of beers. Please don't fall out the side of the vehicle. That would not be good. I do not want to have to go fishing for all of them. And this is kind of another reason why I kind of would like a sprint button in this. If we are going to have to walk around trying to find the town on foot now, I would kind of like to be able to travel that little bit faster rather than just pondering around as we do. Also, this boat is slightly turning to the left on its own. I'm not quite sure why that is, but there we go. Do we have... I guess that's just for a reverse. Like I say, I don't think we're going to have gears to be worrying about here, but I guess, yeah, that's just for reverse if we happen to get ourselves completely wedged. Well, it is a nice day for sailing across a lake. It's a much, much bigger lake than I was expecting, I will be honest. Well, I think I spy something in the distance. That looks like a church spire? Something going on over there. I see buildings at least. I see civilization. Oh, the beers have rolled over. Well, I mean, you say I can roll anything. Oh, no, they've righted themselves again. No, you were... I so nearly managed... Oh, come on, beers. If we turn that way, can we get the beers to roll over? I do actually now need to steer this way. Oh, no. I've found a new game. I've found a new game within a game. Can we make the case of beers fall over? Well, no, it's actually now sorted itself out a lot neater than it was before. Oh, that's rubbish. There's no fun in that. We're nearly there, though. We're nearly there. There'll be something to entertain you on these long boat drives. Sails? I don't know. Sails. Not that we have sails to be worrying about, but you get what I mean. I'm slightly concerned if I just abandon my boat, it's going to float away. I don't know if that's a thing that can happen. Can we see a shop? I kind of want to get as close as possible. No, the beers are almost completely righting themselves. Bugger. That's not fair. Oh, now they're escaping again. That looks like the road into town. So perhaps if we just park up over here, we need to roll the beers again. I don't know what's going on with them. We should probably not beach the boat, otherwise we might never get it back. That looks like the road into town. So if we just kind of abandon our boat here, maybe what's that over there? Is that like a jetty for us? Should we be parking? That's like a trailer for a boat. That is kind of a jetty. Sorry, I lied. There we go. Okay, so we've made it to town. A slightly arduous journey, but nevertheless, we have all made it. Wait, where's the engine shut off? An anchor? We kind of crashed the boat a little bit. Never mind. It's fine. We'll leave driving mode. Beers, stay put. In fact, we'll get another one while we're at it. It was definitely needed after that journey. Right. The slow walk into town, I think. Are we okay? We're a little bit stuck. Okay, we're a little bit stuck on the jetty there. Now we must enter the town and try and find the shop somewhere. Could you not crash about so much over there, boat? I can hear you all the way over here. The beer's doing their own rolling. Low texture trees. probably shouldn't go and play. This kind of reminds me a little bit of DayZ from... God, I used to play around DayZ with a lot of mods. Oh, there are other cars about. Hello. Don't mind me. Okay, that might be how I die. I might be prattling around, distracted and looking at other stuff and get run over. That is a really distinct possibility. Anyway, I digress. Oh, I know why I should have bought the van around here so I could have stored, carry more than one thing at a time. That would probably have helped. I guess food is my primary concern because we've got plenty of beers to be getting on with. Where is the shop, though? I have looked on the interweb, so I know roughly what it looks like, but I don't quite know whereabouts it is. I think it's next to the pub. So, that's it there. That would be the shop right there. Good! We've found the... I really want to move faster. This is really annoying. I know, in reality, you wouldn't probably be running, but you would have the option to if you wanted to. And I would quite like to at this moment in time, because the shop's there. I don't know if me jumping around makes my fatigue go up any more. You will also notice there is a urine bar as well, if we go find a tree. And I think it is P? It is P. Yeah. It's a very amusing game, this one. I love how you have to hold it down the entire... This is the longest wee in history. And there we go, that'll do. Bugger it. No, wait. Stop weeing. Please stop weeing, dude. Do we have to go the whole way? Okay, fine. We'll go the whole way. And then we're done. Okay, we don't really want to be walking into the shop while weeing. That would not be good. Now, check the road. Do not want to get run over. Not that I could do anything if it does look like we're being run over. Also, if you want to get order car parts, I believe you have to bring the order form and stick them in the mailbox here. Ah! Hello! I have come from miles away. Are you a robot? Hey. Maybe we have a robot attendant here. What have we got to possibly buy here? Plenty of stuff. Can we actually... Yeah, okay, I definitely think we have a robot serving us. Okay, so beer case is that. We need some food. Can we get into this? We can't get into that. What's got like the most... what's got like the most regeneration of food? Ooh, we've got pizzas. We can buy pizzas. We can buy sausages. We can buy macaron box. If we click on that, does he... I don't know where it goes. So if we get a couple of them and a couple of pizzas and so on, please all put this in one bag. Otherwise, I'm going to be screwed. Basically, sure. We got a couple more of them. That should sort us nicely. Total cost 89. Oh, we got plenty of money. So if we buy that, oh, it does all put it in a nice bag. That's cool. Right. Let's not drop this. Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Robot Person. There's a petrol station over here. We've got the pub around the corner, so we can go in there. Can we actually go in the pub? Right, I'm going to put, apart from the one car that we have seen, this is quite a ghost town, so I think if we just drop that down, okay, it's not going to spill everywhere, that's fine. Ooh. Oh, we can't go in the pub. Maybe it's a time of day thing. Oh, wait, hold on. We're breaking into the pub. Can we, no, we can't steal anything through there. Not worked. Right, let's get our bag of groceries. If we can pick that up. There we go. It's all good. Right, if we could not be crouched. Stand up. There we go. Right. Now begins the long walk and then sail back home. And we are nearly home at last. Right. We might actually, after some 20 minutes of faffing around getting some food, we might actually now get to the important business at hand, which is building a car. Right, and we are parked a little bit better this time around. We shall leave the driving mode. Fantastic. Right. In fact, my business for today was... Oh, God, are we going to be able to pick up... Come on. There we go. Got the shopping bag. That can go on the jetty. And most importantly... Our case of beer. We may have fallen in the river a little bit. River? Lake? That's more like it. Right, okay. Let's go and stick all of this in the van. Because I'm lazy, rather than doing two trips, I may as well, seeing as we brought the van over here, oopsie, may as well dump these in there. Now, my plan for this episode, after having gone and got all the food, is going to be hopefully get the tractor working, and then we're going to lift up the car. Now, I'm not sure quite how well that is going to work. We will very quickly find out, I suspect, and learn that it's not going to work at all. I'm hoping it will, but you know what my luck is like with this. Right, door. Okay, I think that, yeah, right. Okay, we hold, thank you to the people that told me if you hold it down, that will get the doors to lock shut rather than have them flapping around. As funny as it was having the door flapping around, it is quite useful to actually have them close. Right, okay, now we want to put it into a reverse. Aha! We are, see, wrong, well, I guess either way we could see where we're going. We'll get the van turned around. Well, it's nice to know that the boat is actually there and we don't have to go too far. To be fair, I'm not actually sure whether it's quicker to go by boat or by car to the shops. It's probably more fun to drive because the boat, it is literally just a straight run across the lake. Let's try and not spin the van around. Right. I don't actually know how we get the food out of the shopping bag, but we shall go and do that first. And then we shall go around the corner and hopefully acquire a tractor. A tractor that works today would also be a good part. Alright, food bag. Oh, no, we have to faff around, aren't we? Trying to click on the bugger. Right, down, food, find the right point to click on. There it is. Food, come with, ooh, hello. Hello, physics. I'm glad that it bags it all up and we don't have to worry about carrying stuff. I assume we have to carry, like, the case of beer or whatever separately. So we stick that in there, and then if we press F... Ah! There we go. It all explodes into bits and pieces. Awesome. Okay, we've got plenty of food to be getting on with. I could... If you really wanted to, you could roleplay it and go and put it in the fridge. But I don't think it goes off. We will quickly find out, I guess. Okay, you know what? Because I don't trust this game and because of everything this game has done so far to me... We are going to put some of these, I'll put a couple of these in the fridge, just in case it does go off and we come back and it's all moldy. I'll have some of these here just in case, so we don't have to panic and like quickly run our way across the... I guess you could probably just sort of put the bag in there when you get home and that will kind of just spew them out into the fridge. Okay, that's just to be on the safe side. I don't think it will, but I could be wrong. Now, that bit there is done. The beer is still in the truck. In fact, we have a couple more before we go drive the tractor. That's definitely the way to do it. And then we can kind of just leave it in there for now, and we shouldn't have to worry about our thirst for a little while. And the next one. I wonder if any cars actually come up this way. I don't know. I certainly haven't seen anything appear up here, but I guess that's not impossible. Right, so probably easier just to enter that. Door closed. I think I left the van on. Did I leave the van on? I did leave the van on. I don't know why that was... Oh, what's in driving mode? I don't know why that wasn't driving then. Maybe I'll put it out of gear or something. We shall see. Right, so put it in reverse. There is definitely nothing behind. There's just the cans. I wonder how long they stay around before they despawn. Right. Through the gears we go, and now we have our lovely fun time of fighting with the tractor to try and figure out how the bloody hell we get it to move again. I'm hoping in the saving and reloading and so on, the tractor is going to magically start working again, because couldn't figure out why it stopped moving. And nobody else had any ideas either. I'd looked on the internet, and I'm struggling to find ideas as to what caused that to have issues. So there we go. Handbrake is... on, so that's just isn't going to go anywhere, and ignition, we'll turn it off. I don't know if we have to worry about petrol for this or not. I'm not sure on that. One time it will stop working, and then I'll realise we do. Okay, that, I don't think I closed that properly, but never mind. Dear God, tractor, please work, because I want to be able to lift the car up so we can actually work underneath it, rather than having to try and find the bolts through the floor all the time. Okay, door is shut. Let's get comfortable. Enter the driving mode. Turn our... Oh, no, our tractor did actually turn on first time. Oh. There we go. Right, tractor is on. Okay, now if we put it into gear and then we release the handbrake. Bugger, it's not fixed. Okay, that's definitely... definitely should be. Ah, there we go. I think we might not have quite got the position right with the handbrake. That might have been what was causing us problems. Good news, everyone. The tractor's going. We are going to do the most precarious of lifting maneuvers. If this go wrong, we might be in, this series might be in a little bit of trouble. We might have to restart, because I don't know if there's much we can do if we completely and utterly bugger the car up with this. If it goes right, though, it's going to make working on it 10 times easier and slightly less glitchy. I say slightly less glitchy. I don't know. I'm not sure on that. I mean, this is literally only until we've got the wheels on, and then I guess we can put it inside the shop. All right, so we put that... Oh, that's not reverse. That's not reverse. That should be reverse. Ah, fantastic. Right. Oh, God. I'm slightly nervous about this one. All right. There's a forward gear. Okay. Now, what we're going to want to do is stop the tractor for a second. So if we go... that button. We want to left click on the hydraulics. That should bring it down. I'll probably make sure I'm not going to crush the car. No, I think we're good. I think we're clear. Bring that down, and that will be that. Now, if we very, very gently bump into it, let's go and have a check. Before I go and start lifting that up, have a check that that's gone in the right place. It has not. No, I don't know why we lift the car up by the roof. That's probably not going to be a good idea, is it? The issue is, I think, here, the car... because the grass that we're on is a little bit lower than the car. Lifting up by the roof might not be the dumbest idea I've ever had. As stupid as that is, we're going to drive forward a little bit more just to see what happens. That is the phone call. Phone call, hello. I'm coming as quickly as I possibly can because I can't possibly jog at all here. And you will give me a thing for some money, possibly. Hello, you'd like to buy a flatbed of firewoods. You can deliver them to you at any time. So you're... Okay, you're over there. I love how... He's just rung up and said, yeah, come bring it round whenever. Finish your car in 3 months' time if you want, and I'll still pay you. I was kind of... this is the only the second time I got a phone call. I was kind of expecting them to send it to a specific day or something, but apparently not. It is just, yeah, whenever you feel like it. I'm in the middle of a very delicate procedure at the moment that could go horribly wrong in trying to lift a car up. Right. We will get this done when other things stop distracting us. Right, okay, we're good. We're going to enter driving mode again. I left the door open, but never mind. Right, okay, no, that's not gonna go in, is it? All right, plan. Through the gears to find a reverse. This is going to be really, really, really precarious buggers in a second. So if we just lift that up a little bit, kind of there-ish, then we find a forward gear... Then we're going to kind of skewer through the door hole and like so, perhaps. I mean, to be fair, I don't actually need to... I don't actually need to lift the car up a huge amount. I just need to be able to get like the crawling mode underneath it. Okay, so the forks are in. And that's not going to fall off, I don't think. The forks are most of the way through. I'd like it to be a little bit longer. Okay, guys, are we ready? Everything could go terribly wrong. My trip across the water could well have been wasted if this doesn't quite work out how I hoped it does. But we've got to give it a try, so here we go. Unfortunately, I can't actually watch it as we do it. Front hydraulics up. Oh, yeah, it's looking pretty solid so far. I'd say that's pretty... It's kind of... Oh, no, don't do that. Oh, God, I forgot I was in driving mode. Okay, we nearly crashed into the house. We nearly crashed into the house, and I don't really want to reverse when we have the car lifted up like that, because I suspect the car would fall off again. I mean, it's pretty sturdy. I say that as I'm jumping on the car. Are we sturdy? Oh, no. Okay, jumping on the car was a really bad idea. Okay, if we don't prat around like a moron, this might be okay. Oh, the car is twisting for seemingly no reason. If that can just settle itself out... I mean, I would not... Oh, no, I would not be doing this. I would not be doing this at all. However, can we use our head to knock the car about? Might work. You know, it might work. It's not going to work, is it? It's not going to work at all. It was worth a try, I feel. But that is unfortunately glitching its way sideways, and it is now going to whack into the house. It held briefly. It did hold on quite briefly. I've got to try something. Right, while it's still up there, we will get into here. I think we can... there's my toolbox. I remember where I put it. I think we can... I'm trying to remember the order of the parts now that go on. Can we get to these yet? Shall we try sticking the front left strut on the car and just see what the physics does? I'm not sure though that this is quite the bit that needs to go on. Now I think we might... Do we need to do... actually, I know what we can put on. We can put on the right left. I think we can just stick this in... We're going to have to really get right crouched down. I think we can just stick this on somewhere around about here-ish. There we go. Okay, so physics doesn't get too angry with me doing that. I mean, this is literally the most precarious vehicle I've ever worked on. And, I mean, health and safety would have an absolute field day about this one. I love it, though. I absolutely love it. It's ingenious, awful, awful solution, this one. It really is. I'm going to get squashed. I'm going to get squashed here in a minute. But it is working. It means that we can... get to... Is it an 11 that we need here? No. Maybe a 12. Aha! 12. So, yeah. This is the most unelegant solution of all time ever. But it's working. It means that I can get to this bits of the car and kind of have a look around and see what I'm doing a tad better. And we are almost at the stage where we can put the wheels on it. And once they're on it, then that's... a little bit easier to work on. We can kind of move the car about that bit better. I mean, if it works at the end of the day, really, isn't it? That's the important part in all of this. God damn. I was kind of hoping the lifting it up by the tractor was going to be a little bit smoother. I will be honest. I don't know why I thought it would be. In fact, shall we go turn the tractor off? So that things can't go horribly, horribly. Well, I guess if we squish the car against the wall, it doesn't really matter if it moves around a bit. Right, ignition off. There we go. Then we can close that door. In fact, we can lock that door, kind of shut it fully. Well, things have taken a turn for the dangerous. We've got food, so we should be good. We've got food, we've got beer, although the beer... Oh, bugger. The beer is at the other place. And my I should have chucked the beer in the tractor and brought that back. Not that we are too thirsty at the moment. We have bits and pieces in here to attach to the car. Let's have a look. What have we got? Steering. I probably need to put in some of the steering rods. Do we need to put these in first before we go for the... God, I can't remember now which order these bits and pieces go in here. Before we go and put the, what's it called in? The shock absorbers and stone of the front struts. I'm not sure on that. I had a feeling it was the struts first. But it could well be. It could just be that I was clicking at the wrong point. Yeah, let's go have another try with these. I mean, at the end of the day, these are going to have to go in. Ah! It was the front. I knew it was. I'm not going mad. I was clicking a little bit too low down with these. Right, we'll put this other one over the other side. And then we've got to tighten these up. Don't forget to tighten stuff up. It's all very well and good putting stuff around. I guess actually, probably the other thing I keep forgetting. It's not going to just snap into place. You've got to have it. Oh, quickly. Oh, bugger. Strut. Yarish got to twist it around until it is vaguely pointing in the right direction. It will sort itself out to an extent, but it does still have to be some point in the right direction. Okay, we're going to need to get our toolkit back. Toolkit, come here. No. Toolkit. Oh, no, wait, that's why, because we're not in the right mode. Why are we not picking that up? Why are we not picking the toolkit up? I don't know, I'm confused now. Why is that not working? Toolbot. Oh, okay. Sure, whatever, game. This is not a problem you have. I mean, there are many problems you face when building a kit car, project car, whatever you want to call it. One of them isn't how on earth do you pick up the toolbox, normally, anyway. Right, I think we need... shall we have a guesstimate at what spanner we need? Aha! Fantastic, right. Then we can put the front struts on, and then we can do that the other side as well. I would recommend when you're building it that, unless you happen to remember what size everything needs, make sure you're doing both sides at the same time. Otherwise, you're going to get confused if you're kind of working on one side and then have to go to the other side. And it just saves a little bit of time, I feel, at least going through and doing it like this, than keep sort of chopping and changing and whatnot. There we go. That's on there. Does this door still open? That should probably be a good test. It's perfectly safe. Well, some progress has been made. Oh, no, wait, I need to close that, because otherwise we're going to get stuck trying to get... No, wrong way. Otherwise, I think the car twisting about might get us stuck. I think we need to... We might need to put this... I don't know what order this stuff here is going. I know this needs to go in quite early on, but I don't know if I need to put this in first, and then we can put the other stuff in, or quite which way around. Aha! Wait, what? That's not where the steering rack goes, or the steering column goes, game. Okay, so, right. We do need the other bits and pieces for it to go into first. So if we go and get this, and then we try and find the right tick bit for it. Oh, Christ. This is... Now we're playing really dangerous. Climbing around on top of the car. Maybe we need something else. We probably do. Wait, hold on. You can go back in there. Maybe we need... steering rack first. Maybe we mount this in here first, and then we mount them onto it, possibly. Can we go and find wherever the magical tick mark is? Oh, towing hook. I know I don't want a towing hook at the moment. Okay, maybe we need something else to connect it to. I'm not sure what else we would need to connect it, because don't we bolt that on there? Okay, right, so maybe I was just dropping it from a weird angle then. So we put that on there, and then we go to these, and then we need a different one. Probably that one. Maybe not that. Oh, wait, hold on. Aha, it is that one. I'm getting good at this. I say that, my car is still wobbling. To be fair, there's slightly less glitchy physics going on now that I've done this than it was when I had it on the floor and was doing stuff. That can go there. I've also just noticed I didn't tighten up these. I'm really glad I noticed these at the time I did, because we only tightened it from the top. That could have gone disastrously wrong. First drive with the car and the whole suspension falls apart. There are four of them to do on this. Oh, hello. Oh, whoa. Oh, bugger, the car's... That's a big rock from the car there. There we go. There's the other one. There are four to do down here. We're good. We're good. Progress is being made. Steady progress is being made on the car. We're actually getting the front sort of steering lot sorted. And then what I'll do to finish this episode off, we will get this front steering rack done. Get the steering column in. Is there another one to do down there? Or was that just them? I think it was just them. Did I actually do that? I didn't do the steering rack bit from this side, did I? Right, put that in there. That's done up. They're done up from the bottom on both sides. My car is very nearly falling over. In fact, we should probably be able to put the steering column in now, because now it'll have its bit to attach to. Haha! We do! Excellent. Excellent indeed. Do we need to do up any bolts? I feel like surely there must be something to do up on that. Maybe it does just slot into place there. God damn it. Car, could you behave yourself for just 1 minute? It is quite bent and buckled. Apparently, there's kind of no real way to fix the bending that you get when you're kind of running across it. There's a way to kind of change a file in the... there's the thing that we need to do. There's a way to change a file in the game kind of information to fix up the bends and so on for the vehicle. So it's a little bit cheaty, but that's just what you have to do, really. Right. That's on and tightened there. For the last bit of the day, we will get the... Scratch back down again. I keep going to putting that away, and that's not what you've got to do. You see, keep it on you. We will get these little buggers put on. I don't know what's the difficulty with these project cars, really. which side was this? I didn't pay any attention to it. Front left. Right, so we want to go around over here. And then we want to play the game of guess the angle to put stuff at to make everything happy. Oh, there it was. Aha! And then two. Now I'm getting into it. Now I'm kind of knowing what I'm doing ish in all of this. Are you at that one? Nope. That one? Possibly. No. 12. That's it. There we go. A little bit of juddering from the car. It's okay. Ooh. That will tighten itself up correctly. It did look like it does. There's also, and I don't know what. Can we get a look? I'm trying to figure out. There does look like there's another one that needs to be done up. Oh, crap. We've got a peer button, don't we? There. That. There's just a bolt sort of floating. Oh, maybe it's just a glitchy texture or something. Because there's definitely nothing else that I can tighten up here. That's done. Oh, there's them to tighten up, though, in there. Although they'll be tightened onto the gearbox. So that's okay. Yeah, don't worry. I'm just seeing a loosened bolt, and it's making me nervous. Right, final part of the vehicle. We're getting hungry, we're getting tired, and that's just me in real life, not the game. Where is this going to sit? Oh, I had it. A second. Where's it gone? There it is. Okay, and then tighten that up. And that should be steering. Not that we have a steering wheel on the car, but we should have steering. We are getting there with our, I believe this is supposed to be a Datsun 1000, Datsun 100, something like that. Our project car, my summer car, is a little bit more complete than it was last time. We have steering in place, a lot of the front end has been worked on. We don't actually have too much in the way of running gear to do. We've only got that little bit there left. So we've almost got the running gear on the car, and then we can put it down from this terribly dangerous lift that we have going on. But this lift system really did work, actually. There is a much neater way of doing it. However, it bloody worked. That's going to be it for this video, guys. Thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye. It's a little bit wonky, but never mind.